So I don't know whether Tilak is nervous, but I am definitely nervous sitting next to Tilak. Because he's a young guy for Tilak. So before I start, a big round of applause to Tilak. All of you, I mean, many of you have heard of him on social media, on a press. But those who have not got a time to catch about Tilak Mehta, Tilak Mehta is an entrepreneur. Can you hear me in the back?
No. In the back.
If you are not able to hear me, then keep quiet. Okay. So Tilak is an 8th grade student of Garodia International School, Ghatkopar. And while doing that, he actually started his own company known as Papers and Parcels. So Tilak, you know, wonderful. So before we start, I wanted to ask you, how do you feel to grab all this attention being a young entrepreneur, a kid entrepreneur, whatever they call, and starting your own journey?
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and of course, my dear friends. So it is amazing to get, like, to be recognized on the biggest of the television channels, or newspapers, and radio stations. But as most of our favorite Spider-Man says, with great power comes great responsibility. So to meet up with people's expectations, that is one challenge. But it is amazing that I'm getting this exposure at such a young age.
Wonderful. So can you, for the benefit of the audience, can you tell exactly about your business in, let's say, 2 minutes, what exactly Paper and Parcel does?
So our business and our business model is quite simple. We are the makers of Ola and Uber, of the Dabba Walas. So if you download our application Papers and Parcels, you just like Ola and Uber, if you just at a click of a button, the taxi comes wherever you are and takes you for a ride. So the same way, before 1 PM, you just have to enter the pickup address and the drop address. A service provider comes to your doorstep without any contract or commitment, picks up your parcel. You can live track the parcel all the way through with the prior notification of the customer who comes to your doorstep and delivers it on the very same day. And all of this starting at rupees 40. And we have also collaborated with the Dabba Walas for a delivery.
Great. And how did this idea come to your mind of, you know, doing this business?
So as Sir Plato rightly says, necessity is the mother of invention, and my story revolves around necessity to invention. I had gone to my uncle's place at Borivali. When I came back to Ghatkopar, I realized that I'd forgotten my books at my uncle's place. I called up my father and asked him if he could send some peon or driver to get my books collected. He called me after a few while and said that today there is no peon or driver available. Maybe you will have to wait till tomorrow. So I searched on Google some courier companies which could help me out. I found very few ones. They costed 250 to 300 rupees. I asked my father for 300 rupees to pay to the courier company. But that night, he sat with me and he said that I had to be more responsible, as 300 rupees could give someone's 1 day's salary. And like, you are just spending it, you're just spending the cost for the courier, for the delivery. So I wondered, how do people who do not have a peon or driver manage to get yourself delivered on the same day within the city of Mumbai? I thought, why not start a company which would do same day delivery of Mumbai, in Mumbai, and that too at a reasonable cost. So that was the idea, and today we are an established company.
Wonderful. A big round of applause for a generation of an idea. Okay, so, you know, in this age, and we see a lot of people, you know, I have, you know, son and daughter of your age. You know, many of them are busy with playing with Rubik cubes, PlayStations and all that stuff, and soccer and all. And on one hand, you are talking about dealing with Dabba Wala who are almost 3 times or 4 times of your age. So, it's a bit darling, you know, when you are talking to all these people, and how to manage this kind of a transition. On one hand, you are playing with your friends. On the other hand, you are dealing with your Dabba Walas or your organization.
So, two things. After my journey of Papers and Parcels, what I've understood is that age is just a number, and just a number. If you can prove your thoughts with your action, somebody has to believe you. And the second thing, when you have to do schooling and tuition and sports all together, one thing that I've understood is something can be a priority or an option. And my mentor was a priority for me, and when something is a priority for an individual, you automatically find time to deal with it.
Wonderful, wonderful. So, I mean, you are saying that the idea has no age. As long as you have an idea and you believe in it, then people will have to follow. People will actually do that. Wonderful. People will be. I know I'm going to ask you a tricky question. On one end, you have school, exams, you have submissions, you have Viva and all that stuff. On the other hand, you have company, dabbawalas, managing profit, loss, and all that stuff. How do you manage your day and a week?
Like before I got into papers and parcels, I used to always hear time management karo. I used to always hear about importance of time management, but I never actually knew what it is until I got in here. But I think time management is the key to balance everything. So just to explain my daily schedule, I have schools, tuition and sports in the weekdays, and along with that I check my emails and have a conference call with our team to understand what is the progress today and what do we have to improve on. And in the weekends or in the holidays, I spend minimum 6 to 8 hours in the office each day working on what improvements can I make in that.
Wonderful. So this is how you have divided your time. So it doesn't make you suffer on your studies and all?
All thanks to my mom. She has been prioritized things and nothing has
been. She studied on your behalf? Yeah, mom dad ko ghar pe kaam pe laga diya aur idhar dusre ko kaam pe laga diya. Wonderful. Wonderful. So tell me one thing, and rather two things. One is in this entire process of papers and parcels, I'm sure there are a lot of moments of high, and there are a lot of moments of low also. So I want you to pick up one, let's say, moment of high that you feel, wow, this is something which I really did well. And I also want to pick up one moment of low on day you felt that, oh shit, where I landed, why did I do this, itna jaldi kya tha. So I want you to describe both if possible.
Okay, so moment of high I would like to say two. First, when I was invited by Forbes India as the youngest Forbes panelist ever.
Wow.
And when I was seen at the and also second, when I was called by the Chief Minister of Maharashtra, Shri Devendra Fadnavis, and after the Fadnavis to discuss about papers and parcels at Varsha India Bangalore. So that is I'm really find that people actually have recognized my talent and it's amazing. And again, today I'm here and empower motivating students. That's amazing.
Wonderful. So I'm very happy that you put me also in the leagues of Manishkurwalas and Devendra Fadnavis, so you know, I'm really happy about it. Tell me about your moment of any point of time you thought that, yeah, why I got into this?
So,
one time
I
was born in Manishkurwala.
We didn't operations which would connect Greater Mumbai on the very same day. Next thing,
tougher and the third is even tougher and all. So you can't be quitting. If you are going ahead and you are getting challenges, that means you are going ahead. If you are not getting challenges in life, that means nothing is happening in your life. So I think that's a great learning that you have. And I don't know how many of you know, Tilak is also a diehard fan of Messi. And probably I think that is what is also coming from, you know, this. So if I have to draw analogies, Tilak, between football or soccer and this, and you are, let's say, a godfather or a role model Messi, how would you, draw lessons from that?
So whenever you watch Lionel Messi's match, sometimes I can't because they last up to 3 a.m. in the morning. But the ones I do watch, I understand how teamwork and collaboration with the team actually helps. and I try to implement that with the team. And that is why I say Papers and Parcels is not Tilak Mehta and Papers and Parcels today.
Wonderful. Great. Tell me, you have built a team and I'm sure nobody would be younger than you in your team. Everybody would be elder than you obviously because you can't have a child level. But you can be the owner of the company. So when you deal with all the elders and you, because you are the boss of the business and you have to give instructions to people and all, how easy or difficult you find to build a team of almost people who are almost double in your age?
Okay, so firstly, I don't think it is, of course it is not child labor and I am pursuing my dream. Second, I would say that first it is really difficult to convince people to get on board. Like just imagine you are being interviewed by a 13-year-old boy. Like nobody will be convinced first. But when I actually share my idea with them and I talk to them, they understand how serious I am and what I am talking about. And then selecting the right people to work with us. So we work as a flat organization. It is not like I am the boss or somebody else is the boss. So we work as a flat organization and we work smoothly, function smoothly. As I interact with the team chair, it's like I am just a part of. So we are all friends.
Oh, super. So it's not your team or a subordinate. They are all a friend and you know that's how you actually build the organization. Last two questions and then I'll open. I'm sure your audience will have something to interact, so I don't want to be the only one asking questions. You should get a chance. When we started Empower and we started teaching or you know making nurturing entrepreneur mind among students, we were often asked the question, why are you doing it with children? Let them study, let them grow, and then after that they can think of business and all. And here is the classic example in form of Tilak Mehta who is actually doing that when you are 13-year-old. So what is the message that you would like to give it to young people of your age?
So first, fortunately my parents did not think that way. In fact, my father was happy that I'm not just staying with a problem, instead dealing with it and giving it a structure of business. But I would like to tell to all the parents who are present here that actually if your child or anybody has any idea, please do support them. And I assure that instead of me, your child will be sitting here and making you proud there.
Wonderful. And the last thing is, what is your message to all the people of your age sitting there? What is that thing that you would like to tell them?
I would like to say, explore your ideas, let it establish in the real world, and never let failure get to your heart, and never let success get to your head, because failure is not the opposite of success, it is a part of success.
Wonderful. So some of these quotes I think you are saying, you should start writing a management book, and I think, you know, we'll buy the first write of that, because the thought process is so good. So with this, I want to hand over mic to some of you who would like to ask questions. Let's restrict it to 3 or 4 because of the interest of time. But please ask relevant questions to him.
Actually, I have 2 questions. You can choose whichever you wish to. One is, what was the role of your school in this entire dream come true? And the second question is that, do you ever think that you will miss your childhood?
Okay, so I can answer both the questions. So school has been really cooperative throughout the journey. Sometimes when I have to take half days for meetings or events, they give me half day without any hesitation and they take extra classes for me so that I can cope up with the syllabus. And I actually never think that I'll miss out on my childhood because the exposure that people get at the age of 30s and 40s, I'm getting it now. So in fact, that is a privilege for me. And I enjoy with my friends, nice days and all, musti and maza.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just have a very technical question. So when you're you talked about there's no middleman in place. You just take the parcel and you deliver it to the place. So how do you ensure that the parcel is not something, you know, that should not actually be delivered to another person?
Yeah, so basically if there's something, so when you mentioned the terms and conditions, if there's some illegal product that you're sending, the whole reliability is yours. So nothing comes on us because we are just the first people who pick it up and deliver it. It's not us who have to actually check what is in there. Even though we can according to terms and conditions, but yes.
Anybody else?
Don't get intimidated,
yeah?
Ask questions.
It's fine. Even I am a child, so such questions could be fun.
So how do you see the future of your papers and parcels? How do you see, let's say, 5 years down the line? Do you have a plan for that?
Yes, I see papers and parcels expanded pan-India. To be very honest, we just don't receive like inquiries for franchise not in other states, but also in countries like Canada, US and Dubai. And we would like to provide Goenka services to as many people as possible.
So my question is that even I have similar interests in, you know, doing starting my own firm or something like that. But my question is, you were just a kid when you started this business, right? How did you actually think that, what was the first step that you took as a help from the outside world or somebody who was older to you? I mean, how did you get the right connection to something?
So, first thing, I am still a kid. And then like the first step was I had to figure out the right delivery partners. So for that I started interacting with the ones who came to my calling. So first step meeting would be interacting with people, building better connection with them, better relationship with them. And what I've learned is if you have if you can actually do human management, they will take care of you, and then nothing is more important than human management.
Anyone from this side? Any questions for Tilak? Yeah? Yeah.
Why did you give this thing, papers and parcels?
Nice question. So basically whenever we used to talk about what do we want to do, we always used to say we are going to deliver papers and parcels, we are going to deliver this, so how are we going to deliver papers and parcels? So we used to use that name very frequently, so we thought why not name it Papers and Parcels, and that is the name that is actually, when you think about what the business we are doing, it is really similar, it is really recollective, so that is
it. Anyone? One last question.
Did you or do you have any business consultant who's helping you in growing your business?
So it is not like a business consultant, but we work as a team. So like when we have team meetings, we always think of how do we want to expand or how do we want to improve. So it is a team who is helping.
Okay. Yeah, I don't have a question, but I would definitely say you have a new fan over here. Like really, a big round of applause for this.
Yeah, he has excellent presence of mind, and unfortunately because of the time concept, we couldn't meet, so we are actually meeting him for the first time. We do a lot of sessions in Garuda International as well, but it's wonderful to host Tilak Mehta out here, and we wish all the best here. I'm sure he'll rock, and he's just 30, so he has another, you know, decades and decades for him to conquer, and we wish all the best from all of us, and wonderful journey, Tilak.
Thank you. And the last thing I would like to say is that's our CEO, Mr. Ghanshyam Pare,
okay,
who is quietly sitting and listening.
Ghanshyam, why don't you come on the stage here? No, it's not on the stage. It doesn't matter. So here is Ghanshyam. You want to speak a couple of words? Your experience with dealing with Tilak?
Happened as an accident. He always keeps on telling about his ideas to us, and that is how the whole thing started. I quit my bank job and I joined the company full time. We got an application to implement, things are running fine right now.
Wonderful.